Hi there, Starstream Painting here, and today we're going to be painting this pack donkey. First order of business, as always, is to stick it to the stick tube. We'll bring him up close so you can get a good looky-loo. Sorry about the orange lines, I'm still not entirely sure why my lamp does that. It probably needs cleaned. Ouch. It gets incredibly hot though, so I sorry. Right, I was showing you this pack donkey. All right, let's get started. I think I'm gonna paint him gray. Now, I'm not worried about getting anything on the pack straps because I'm going to come back in and do them next or later. Now, I bet you there are those of you out there who's like, Starstream, how do you know this is a donkey and not a mule? That's a great question. It's its tail. See how it's all one big piece together? Fleshy? And then it comes into the little tuft. That's a donkey trait. A mule would have a tail more like a horse, where it's all hair all the way down. And I know this because of experience. Real world experience. When I was little, we had a donkey. His name was Shorty. He was my brother. He was not a very sociable donkey. He was very handsome. He was a grayish black color. So anyway, I hope you're all having a great day. I'm having a great day because I get to spend it with you. This one I'm having a little problem with because I definitely did not wash it, and it definitely has mold release agent. But that's 100% my fault. I knew better. I just didn't do better. Oh, just as a heads up, because I haven't got around to doing it yet on Steam, Twitch. This isn't a video game. Friday's stream is going to be canceled. I'm going off to do fun stuff. I know it's not exactly the best idea for me to cancel what could be my last stream for a little while, but I'm going to do it anyway because, well, I have plans. And I'm allowed to have plans, too. If you care and that bothers you, go ahead and message me in chat or put it in the comment section. It probably won't change my mind, but, hey, at least you're interacting with the video. How's your Wednesday going? If you're watching this on YouTube and it's not Wednesday, how's whatever day of the week it is going? A little more gray paint. It's taking a lot more paint than I first anticipated to get good coverage. In his rump. In his belly. Making sure we got all the coverage. There we go. I think we got full donkey covered. There we go. Now we're going to go ahead and, what to paint next? Let's paint the base. It's a nice big area. And we're going to paint it green. Ah, dang it, I got green on his. I'm just really globbing the paint on in here. Making a mess. go. There we go. Back to painting. Jeez, I'm shaky today. How do you guys feel about the idea of a finishing stream? Now, what I mean by that is a stream where I just finish miniatures I've already been working on that are so close to being done. They just need a little bit more work. And just streaming that. It'll be miniatures you've never seen, probably never seen me paint because I painted them off stream. But I got a bunch of them that just need a little bit more work to do to be finished, or considerable amount of work to be finished. But they're like this. They're half started. Like at this point in the progress. There's colors on them, but they're not done. Would you guys enjoy seeing that? Or would you rather I just do that on my own time? Because recently I've just been doing that on my own time. Finishing miniatures, I start. All right, next order of business. You know, I started this one, but I'm not feeling it. Need a little more gray to cover up that area. Okay, now let's try again. Start working on the pack. We're gonna start by painting the straps because that's the next thing I know what color I want to paint it. You'll notice sometimes I go in weird orders. Like next logically should not be the straps, but it's going to be the straps because it's the next thing I know what color I want to paint. And sometimes you just gotta go with what you know. And I committed to painting this mini, so I'm painting this mini. And then his harness, his halter. There we go. Next, we're going to go ahead and paint the handle on the pickaxe. Again, we're going with what we know. This miniature was a lot more complicated than I initially thought. First, I was like, yeah, I'm going to be able to bang this out in no time. Nope. Now that I cut it out, I'm like, what color am I going to paint this? What color am I going to paint that? What color am I going to paint this? Now, I believe we've got a canteen or something. We got a box over here. We're going to paint this the same color. Can you see okay? Let me know if you ever can't see. Chances are I've wandered out of frame and don't realize it yet. There we go. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to paint the pickaxe head. Again, not logical, but we're going with what we know. Since I know what color I want it, might as well paint it. It's not the most efficient method, but it's the method I use a lot. Especially on minis with lots of components. I go with what I know. If I know I want it silver, I'm going to paint it silver. If I know I want it steel colored, I'm going to paint it steel colored. Is it the most logical order? No, I probably should have painted that big pack first. But I don't know what color I'm painting that yet. So here we are. There we go. Now I got a jug on there, and I'm going to paint it sky blue. We're probably going to paint another pack on there sky blue too. Just because I got the paint. And it adds a little cohesion. And then, you know what? We're gonna paint this canteen the same blue. Because it's a specialty item and it can be whatever color I want. There we go. Now we're going to go ahead and paint some packs brown. A light brown this time. Which ones? Haven't decided yet. We'll burn that bridge when we get to it. We'll paint this pack this brown. There we go. I saw something else I wanted to paint that light blue. Oh, so close. dropped a drop of water in there. That'd have been bad. There we go. Now I think we're going to paint this bundle over here this light brown. Right after we notice some more blue we need to touch up. A little bit of weird up in there. There we go. I want to paint this little pouch here, this color. Okay. There we go. Nope, I found another wooden bundle. Sorry. Nope, that's the wrong color. Nope, that color, so we'll have to pour out some more. We'll come back and touch it up later. I think we're gonna make this last bundle black. Okay. There we go. There we go. I see a little spot I need to paint gray. And then we'll paint the little donkey's eyes and nose and his mouth. Get out the teeny brush and do that right now while we're thinking about it. Paint his teeny tiny eyes. And we'll paint the inside of his nose. There we go. Should we paint the inside of his ears? Yeah, we're going to paint the inside of his ears too. There. That was a little color. Okay. What was I needing to touch up? Oh yeah, a little bit of gray. Yeah. Ooh, excuse me. Sorry. There we go. Spot at a spot I need a tiny bit of pressure. Touch up. Now we're going to go ahead and dry brush. Well, first we actually need to air dry. Speed dry the painting. Hold on, let me pick out the color I'm going to use to dry brush. This color. Sorry, today I wasn't as prepped as I should have been. Sorry. We're going to go ahead and use the hair dryer to speed dry the paint. So mind your ears. That should be good. Now we're going to go ahead and dry brush. We're going to use a light gray for this because I think it'll look really cool. And we're going to use one of our poofy brushes because I feel like it. Ah, way too much paint. Donkey appears to be particularly dusty. My paint was not apparently dry because I've got smearage all over the place. I like that being, actually I kind of like the smearage. It makes it look like it was originally one color and it's the paint coming off. Okay, and that's our miniature. Let me get it in frame. camera a second to adjust. Start rotating. As always, thank you for taking time out of your busy day to spend it with me. Really appreciate that. Let me see if I can't get a clear shot. I need it for the thumbnail. Yeah, that's not happening today. Camera refuses to focus. There we go. Anyway, thank you as always for taking time out of your busy day to spend it with me. I really appreciate that. Till next time, bye-bye. Thumbs up for you. Okay, bye-bye.